Saurav has this question. It's an interesting question. He says he's 28 years of age. He lives in Bengal, West Bengal. He says he bought a health insurance from an insurance company called the healthcare plan. Sum assured is 3 lakh rupees. Is it a good health insurance plan? I had had a surgery at the age of 12 but forgot to mention that. Will it create any problem in the future?
See, depends on the kind of surgery. Even if it was, let's say, a surgery due to a road accident, ideally, it should be mentioned on the proposal form. The reason is because if, for example, anything that happens because of the surgery, whatever, right? Let's say it's a leg surgery, right? There was something inserted in the leg. Now, after 5 years, after 10 years, that thing goes bad and you need a surgery, then the doctor will obviously declare at the time of treatment that this something happened long back, 20 years back, and because of which you need the surgery again. So it will get rejected. So it's always good at the time of renewal. My suggestion would be at the time of renewal, he needs to go back to the insurance company and declare that.
And renewal is typically every year?
Renewal is every
year. Are all policies a 1 year policy?
So there are 2 year and 3 year policies
okay.
as well.
Okay.
But roughly about 20% of the people who buy health insurance from policies.
So how does Dhruv the pre-existing illness thing work? There is a 3 year limit as per IRDA that after that you cannot reject a claim on a pre-existing. So if somebody has, in his case, probably not deliberately, may have forgotten to mention a particular ailment and 3 years have passed, can it still get rejected for a pre-existing?
See, that's a grey area.
Yeah.
Yes, the IRDA does mandate that an insurance company cannot reject post 3 years, but that's a grey area, to be honest. Companies do reject. And to be honest, companies are not wrong in kind of rejecting it.
Because you've been not so transparent or honest when you took your policy.
See, insurance, there's a principle of utmost good faith.